Hello everyone, welcome you all to Imagination Gallery. Here we try to show you different types of drawings and stories behind it. So if you are an art lover and wants to know the unknown facts, press the subscribe button now. Now let me introduce you to today's topic. Today in our World 2 series, we will draw and explore the world created by America's first people, Native America, and dig into the souls of Native American tribe, Kiowa people. So be a part of this stunning journey, paintings and stories behind Kiowa tribe and Native America. Friends, it's been a long time now we are doing this World 2 series. And we have traveled through many different places, countries, cultures, people, their lives. And of course, it was virtually through the eyes of art. And we are continuing doing this. So when I think about different people, you know, and their history, their origin, I just want to absorb everything of them, all the history. This time, we will discuss the First Nation people. Member of any of the aboriginal people of the Western Hemisphere, Kiowa tribe from Native America. Here in this painting, I have tried to showcase the authentic Kiowa tribe warrior dancers with their authentic attire. Let's explore. Kiowa people are a Native American tribe and an indigenous people of the Great Plains of the United States. They migrated southward from western Montana into the Rocky Mountains in Colorado in 17th and 18th centuries and finally into the southern plains by the early 19th century. In 1867, the Kiowa were moved to a reservation in southwestern Oklahoma. Today, they are federally recognized as Kiowa Indian Tribe of Oklahoma, with headquarters in Carnegie, Oklahoma. As of 2011, there were 12,000 members. The Kiowa language, part of the Tanoan language family, is in danger of extinction with only 20 speakers of that language. There are only 20 speakers for this language as of 2012. Friends, the Kiowa historically had a nomadic hunter-gatherer society. They shared a similar cuisine with their neighboring plain tribes, such as Comanche. The most important food source for the Kiowa and fellow plains nations is the American bison or buffalo. The Kiowa were known for making things of leather, such as boots, clothing, and moccasins, which they also decorate with beads and painted designs. Kiowa men traveled far to trade with their other tribes. Traditional Kiowa religion included the belief that dreams and visions gave individual supernatural power in war, hunting, and healing. 10 medicine bundles believed to protect the tribe became central in the Kiowan sun dance. Kiowa were also notable for their pictographic histories of tribal events, recorded twice each year. Each summer and winter from 1832 to 1939, one or more Kiowa artists created a sketch or drawing that depicted the events of the past 6 months. In the early years of this practice, the drawings were made on dressed skins, while artists working later in the period drew on ledger paper. The National Anthropological Archives of the Smithsonian Institution contain a number of these extraordinary drawings. Now, my dear friends, let's talk about Kiwa people, how their daily life, how they spend their daily life and how they actually live life. What are the segregation of a man and woman responsibilities? So Kiwa woman basically in charge of the home. Besides cooking and cleaning, they make houses. They build her family's house and drag the heavy posts with her whenever the tribe moved. Houses belong to the woman or in the Kiwa tribe. Men were the hunter-gatherers and warriors, responsible for feeding and defending their families. Usually only men became Kiwa chiefs, but both genders took part in storytelling, artwork and music and traditional medicine. Kiwa hunters used bows and arrows. In war, Kiwa men fired their bows or fought with war clubs and hide shields. So you can see all these things here in this painting. They are having these bows and arrows and beaded dresses and everything. Provisions of the 1865 Little Arkansas Treaty forced the Kiwa and Comanche to relinquish lands in Kansas and New Mexico. And the 1867 Medicine Lodge Treaty established a 2.8 million acre reservation in southwestern Oklahoma. The Kiwas lived a typical Plains Indian lifestyle, mostly nomadic. They survived on buffalo meat, gathered vegetables, lived in a teepees, and depended on their horses for the hunting and military uses. The Kiwas were notorious for long-distance raids south into Mexico and as far north as Canada. Now let's have an idea, my dear friends, that what is this Native America? What kind of lands you expect to be the Native Americans lived in? So Indian Territory, also known as the Indian Territories and the Indian Country, was land within the United States of America reserved for the forced resettlement of Native Americans. Therefore, it was not a traditional territory for the tribes settled upon it. The Indian reservation system established tracts of the land called reservations for the Native Americans to live on as white settlers took over their land. Many parts of the Americas are still populated by indigenous people. Some countries have sizable population, especially Bolivia, Canada, Ecuador, Guatemala, Mexico, Peru, and the United States. So here you can expect all the indigenous people are living in Native American land, are all these lands. And the segregation are the Arctic, the subarctic, the Northeast, the Southeast, the Plains, the Southwest, the Great Basin, and California. can enjoy the today's expedition to Native America, the Kiowa tribe. Transmit your feedbacks and suggestions about our drawing sessions here in the comment box. So if you like our drawing sessions and you want to know about different illustrations and paintings and the stories behind it, then do not forget to subscribe our channel. Here's wishing you an amazing week ahead. Stay safe and take care. Bye for now.